Hey folks, Mr. Raven here, and welcome to a brand new series, Subnautica. I have played this game before, but it just dropped a big update, as you can see in the right hand upper corner. It's an early access game, and it's just dropped one in January 2017. So, I thought I would start a new game from scratch. It's been a while since I have played this game, so I thought that would be kind of interesting. So, let's start a new game, and I'm gonna start it as survival. So, yeah, this is a very, very beautiful game, I think. But you'll see in a minute. It's just gonna load up. Ouch.
Greetings, survivor. Great job not dying. To assist you in further survival in emergency situations, you have been issued this personal data assistant. The interface visible now will organize your inventory, display currently available construction blueprints, and holds other valuable information. Please take a moment to familiarize yourself with it.
So yeah, little hectic start there. So, yeah, we survived. I didn't expect that. Well, I did. I kind of like the lady speaking before. It says, great job not dying. So, yeah, this is our inventory. We only have the fire extinguisher. And you get it up and down by tapping tap. Can't remember. Nope. Only tap. This is our outfit. We don't have anything yet. This is the blueprint catalog. I will get more into that when we start building a base. This is new. When we swim away, we have a thing showing where the life pod is. We can change the color of it, and we can set it not showing. And photo album. I haven't taken any photos, and we got some locks that we can go back and read again. And a data bank of all the stuff and things we can go and read. Read about our suits and building materials and stuff like that. So yeah, let's go outside. That's our ship. Hello. It were our ship. Well, they added birds? I don't think that's new. Maybe I just didn't notice it before. But this is a planet. There is just ocean. And that's why it's called Subnautica. Look at this. It's so beautiful. Crystal clear waters, fish swimming around, all kind of different things. So when I play this, I usually go for getting some more oxygen so you don't have to go to the surface as often. And we built everything on this fabricator. Well, almost everything. And it's under equipment and O2 tank. I need glass and titanium. And if we see here in this tab, we need quartz. No, not that one. That one. Quartz to make glass. So we need to find some titanium and some quartz. Let's go back in. Quartz, it's actually easier to find when it's dark because it's lighting up, but this is quartz. Big limestone. Titanium. This debris metal.
Attention, detecting increased local radiation levels. Trend is consistent with ongoing degradation of the Aurora's dark matter drive core due to damage sustained during collision. Continuing to monitor. Oxygen.
So your PDA is warning you when you need to go to the surface and breathe air. It's not gonna show the big arrow up to the surface every time. And it's been changed a little bit. It was just a little bloop bloop oxygen sound. So try to listen to after that if you're not looking constantly on your O2 bar down in the left corner. What do I need more? I have this one, I think, is giving me 4 titanium, so I should have enough. So let's try to swim back. Ooh, and it tells the distance to it now. That's nice. Know how far away you are. I don't think it used to do that. So let's make this grab into titanium. Like that. And the quartz into glass, like that. And let's make us a O2 tank. If we go into our inventory now, you can see we got one O2 tank over in our on our person. You can build more than one, and it will give you more oxygen. So if you're going to go deep, you can build more. Oh yeah, this one is generating first aid kits, and it's doing it every, I don't know, 5 minutes, something like that. It's continuing generating medical kits. So look for the lamps if they're blinking. There is a kit ready for you. So, let's try and find some more materials. Just quick, see what we can get. Ooh, some cover. That's nice. Eat something. Well, okay. If I'm not mistaken, there is some rations and some bottled water in this cabinet. Yeah. Nutrients bar and some water. So, what? Oh yeah, I need to left click. Left click. I don't want to swim around with this fire extinguisher, and so I'm just gonna put it away. Yeah, that's good for now. So you can see the sun is setting. And we can see the stars. Ooh, was that shooting stars? No. That was just burning debris from Aurora. Look at that moon. Look at that planet. Hey, you can see the stars through the planet. Well, I don't think we're supposed to do that. So let's go down under. And you can see it's even more beautiful at night. It's also a little more scarier, but it's also pretty. So I can't remember what I need, so I think I'm gonna take a little bit of everything and go back to the life pod. I do remember that we need these acid mushrooms to make batteries. So let's see. And if you notice this, I haven't been... Oh, scary. I haven't been to the surface for a while, and that's because of the O2 tank. So I can stay under for longer.
Oxygen.
So when you ran out of, when you run out of oxygen, you don't die instantly. You can make it, but you can also die. I'm not playing hardcore, so when I die, I just spawn back at the last base that I entered, I think, but I lose everything in my inventory. So don't die if you've just been on a farming expedition. So let's see, we need some flippers. That's silicon rubber. Silicon rubber is grapevines, seed clusters. Okay. Do I need a scanner? That is a battery and some titanium. Battery electronics. Oh, I can make a battery. So then I can make a scanner. And the scanner is used to scan objects. That's the way you can learn about all the animals and plants, and you can also scan debris from Aurora and get the blueprint so you can build it yourself. So can I build a battery so I can build a lamp? Yeah. No, I need glass, right? I have glass or quartz, and let's build a flashlight. Like so. And every item, if you look in the middle of the screen, has power, so you can run out of power. Until you find the blueprint, you need to keep building batteries, but save the used batteries because they are rechargeable. So So you can recharge them when you get the blueprint for the recharger. So let's see if we can find something to scan, maybe. Are you scannable? Ooh. Sea glider fragment. One of two. So the sun is coming up.
Ooh. Caution. Continued degradation of the Aurora's drive core may cause a quantum detonation. Calculating risk assessment. Death by malnourishment, 7%. By physical injury, 11%. By exposure to radioactive crash site materials, 19%. If the drive core is breached, probability of death increases to 65%. Oxygen.
Hmm. Something is definitely wrong at Aurora. So, yeah. I think we can find some of those clusters over here. What was that? Creep Levine? Yeah. But it was the seed clusters I need, and I think it's the yellow things here.
New blueprint acquired.
New blueprint acquired.
30 seconds.
These are quite cool. Oh, you can suck up the air bubbles. So,
30 seconds.
If you need to, oh, I need to get away. If you need to swim along the bottom for a long period of time, you can swim between those bubbly things. Can't remember what they're called. But I think I got what I needed. Yeah.
Oxygen.
So, the fin should help me swim a little faster. So I'm excited about the fins. So let's see. That was... So we can use those seed clusters for silicon rubber or lubricant. So if you're in doubt, use lubricant. No, don't do that. Thought I heard something. Let's see. Give me some fins. Loading air pump. Pipes. Hmm. So if I build this and some pipes, you can leave that at the surface and take pipes down, and you can get oxygen from the pipe instead of going up and down, up and down. So, oh. I didn't mean to do that. Whoa. How many pipes did I get? Whoa. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or just 5. Well, now I build it. Now we have to see how it works. If it works as I think it does. So, I always start to build my starter base just around the lifeboat. So I think I'm gonna do that. So if I build it down over here, it would be nice to have air at the bottom. Okay. Huh. It sounds kind of funny. Okay. Flexible. So you right click to set it. Well, that's actually kind of smart. And I can pick it up again. Yeah. Well, that's pretty nifty. I like that. Let's see what we need. We need a knife. Let's just put this away for now. Like that. And what do I need to build a knife? I need silicon rubber, of course. Well, I'm gonna swim for some seed clusters, and when I got what I need, I'll bring you back. See you in a bit. So I found this. Ooh. Sea glide fragments. Woohoo! Well, now I have to build that. What was that? Sounded like an underwater horse. A seahorse. No. Let's see what's in here. Limestone. 30 seconds. I need air first, I think.
Oxygen.
Maybe I should build an air tank. Another air tank. Inventory full. What? Yeah, you better swim away.
Radiation readings exhibit characteristics consistent with total degradation. Crystalline matter drive core. A quantum detonation will occur with a probability of 85.5%. Advice observing a 1 kilometer safety range. 30 seconds.
So, she's gonna blow? I think she's gonna blow. So, let's build the knife. Let's see what we need. So the seat light, battery, lubricant, copper wire and titanium. What did I need for the knife? One silicone, right? Yeah, one silicone. I can make some lubricant too, I think. Yep. Copper wire. And the battery. So I need some more copper. Yeah, I think that's it. So let's build the knife. By the way, those four hotkeys is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you can set them as you want. So if I want the flashlight at number 1, I just hold the cursor over the flashlight and push 1. And the scanner is 2. And the knife is 3. Oh, 3. Like that. Yeah, let's make that rubber. Like that. And I needed some copper. Oh, I used it. So if you right click, you can put things into the storage unit with one click. And back in your inventory with one click, right click. Ooh, I should start thinking about some water. So let's look for... You got some different ways of making water. You can... You can... use salt. And... common coral. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's make 5. And you can catch these air sacs or bladderfish. Bladderfish. Ooh, sea glide. Well, I already have it. But if you scan a blueprint you have, you get titanium. Titanium. Comments. Yep. Nope. Whoa. Where is the salt? Oh, salt.
Oxygen.
Oh. I just have to get used to that sound. Salvage. Have a look here. Yeah. So these guys, they have acids coming out of the butts. Like that. And when they explode, it became a cloud. Or becomes a cloud. And if you touch it, you lose HP. But it looks like it wasn't permanent. Whoop. Well, I can't seem to find... more salt than the one. I just need that one copper, and then I can make the sea glide.
Emerge. emergency. Seismic readings suggest a quantum detonation has occurred in the Aurora's drive core. The central dark matter reactor will reach a supercritical state in T minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2.
Whoa. Cool. So, I'm probably not gonna fly home on that. So let's see if I quickly can find some copper. So, yeah, I got one. Let's just pick this up, lead. So now the area around Aurora is radioactive. So I need to build a radiation suit if I need to go near Aurora. So that bladder fish, I can make that into water or I can make it into food, but it's not a good food source. So normally I make it into water. If you make the salt and the coral into bleach, and then you can make it into, I need to hit the right button, there you can make it into water, and it's a bigger bottle, so it gives, remove more thirst. Yeah. Let's see here. Waterproof locker. No. Oh. And it was copper wire. So let's make the copper wire. And then. No, and then. Where was it? There, sea glide. So the sea glide is the first, no, well, 1.5. the first motorized vehicle to get around with, and it has light and a map, a sonic map, so you can, as you can see, it's pretty cool, it's pretty nifty. You come around pretty quick. So yeah. But I think this is going to be it for this time. So I hope you like this new series. Because it's a game I really enjoy playing. It's very beautiful. And I'm excited to see what the devs have put in this game. So yeah, if you like it, please leave a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. And the last thing I want to do is just wish you a great day. Have fun gaming. Bye.